When it comes to batteries, we really need to treat them one at a time. We have three examples here on the cart, all of them that are about 2 years old at the time of this filming. This manufacturer gives you the manufacture date and the ship date in each case. So here we got December of 09, December of 09, January of 2010. And again, a month later is when each of these batteries were shipped. All of these batteries have come back under warranty claim. So let's go ahead and test them right now and see whether or not that we can actually qualify them as a legitimate warranty. We'll go ahead and connect. I've got the lead stud adapters already installed. So I'll connect the positive and negative terminals appropriately. The EXP-1000 turns on, and we're just gonna do a battery test now. So we select battery test, and these batteries are top post, group 31, regular flooded automotive style batteries, and they're rated in CCAs, and these batteries happen to be rated at 700 CCAs. So let's go ahead and test at this temperature. You hold the tool close to the battery, hit it one time, and it's gonna go ahead and complete the test. When we're done with this test, we're gonna go ahead and print out the results, and I'm gonna take a test of all three of these batteries and see if all three of them truly are qualified for warranty judgment. All right, the test is complete and it's a good battery. Let's print out the results for battery one. I'll turn on the printer, and I'll point the tool at the printer, hit the button twice, and we'll get a printed result now for battery number one. We'll go ahead and complete the same test now on batteries two and three in this sequence, again, to verify whether or not each of them truly are qualified for warranty. The first battery tested result was 12.71 volts, measuring 678 CCAs on a rating of 700. Battery number two, we had a good recharge decision because voltage was down to 12.22, but the measured CCA was 580 on that 700 rating. Once that battery is recharged, you will see that the CCAs will also recover and that battery should be fit for service once again. The last battery though, battery number three, measured the highest voltage, 12.92 volts, but it's only 540 CCAs and the decision is replaced. Again, the distinction between the state of charge and state of health. We have to use both of those values in terms of making an appropriate decision as to whether or not the battery is serviceable and can be used in the vehicle.